We will now proceed to meet Dr. Nilanjan Roy. He is the Surveillance Medical Officer at WHO India National Public Health Surveillance Project, Meghalaya. Dr. Nilanjan Roy will talk to us about the treatment required for COVID-19 patients.
A very good morning, dear Principal Madam, teachers and students. On behalf of the World Health Organization Shillong Unit, I welcome you to my office and I will just discuss with you some of the current concerns regarding the coronavirus pandemic, which is now widely known as COVID-19. So you know that COVID-19 is a viral infection which is caused by SARS-CoV-2. It's a very small virus and it causes an infection that results in fever, cough, difficulty in breathing. So we need to be aware about how to suspect that we are infected with this organism. So I will tell you a little bit about how to manage and treat cases of COVID-19. So COVID-19, most of the people who develop the infection, they don't develop symptoms, but they can transmit the disease unknowingly because they do not have symptoms. They will not suspect that they are infected and they will continue to help spread the infection. So we categorize the disease people into two major groups. One is the low risk cases or moderate risk cases, and then there are the high risk cases. Now in the low risk cases and moderate risk cases, what happens is they will experience mild fever, they may have body ache, they may have cough and loose motion, they may even present with headache, and they may also have loss of taste and or smell. Usually the fever is less than 102 degrees Fahrenheit and the oxygen level, that is the SpO2 or the partial pressure of oxygen, is maintained at more than 94% when breathing the room air. Now high risk cases are those people who experience high fever when the fever is more than 102 degrees Fahrenheit and they also have difficulty in breathing, chest pain, and they can even have mental confusion. And most important to remember that the partial pressure of oxygen will be less than 94%. So these are the category of people who will require hospitalization and they may require oxygen support, or even they may require to be hospitalized in ICU and put on ventilation if the disease becomes critical. But as I mentioned, that most of the cases are asymptomatic and they can be safely managed at home. So you must know that what are the symptoms, and if you have symptoms, it is very important that you get yourself tested early. Early testing will ensure that you will not help to spread the infection any further. And also remember that if you need to travel, then also you may require a negative COVID-19 report. Not only you, dear children, even if any of your family members, they exhibit symptoms of COVID-19, they also need to be tested at the earliest. Now, as I said, that most of the cases are going to be asymptomatic or mildly symptomatic, and these are the patients who can safely be managed at home. Now, what is to be done if you go for home isolation? You must ensure that the patient does not mix with the other family members. So best is to isolate that person and keep adequate distance of at least 6 feet or 2 meters from the other family members at all times. And wherever possible, The patient should be kept in a single room which is well ventilated. There must be cross ventilation, and as far as possible they must have a separate toilet facility. Now, if you do not have that, then you can contact the government helpline at 14410 and opt for institutional quarantine, which is being organized by the government. The other things that you need to do is that the infected person's, you know, utensils and clothing should be kept separate from the other normal family members, and the patient as well as all other people should always wear masks. So if you have a N95 mask, the one that I am using, you can use a single mask. It should fit properly. You see that where, as I'm speaking, you can see the mask move, and as I'm breathing, you can see the mask move, which means that this is properly, you know, fitting my face. So it should not allow air entry. If you do not have N95 mask, then you require a medical or a surgical 3-ply mask, and use of double mask is important. So along with a medical or surgical mask, you can use a cloth mask, or if you do not have a cloth mask, you can use 2 3-ply masks. So double masking is very important. And then regular, you know, monitoring of the symptoms. Like, you have to check for fever with a thermometer to ensure that the fever is less than 102. And also try to keep a pulse oximeter at home and keep on checking the oxygen concentration using the pulse oximeter, which will tell you what is the oxygen saturation. And this has to be monitored at least 3 to 4 times in a day. This can be easily and safely done at home. Remember that you require to be well hydrated. So take enough warm liquids like soups, you can take juices, and eat light nutritious meals. It is very important to maintain the nutrition and hydration, and also maintain proper hygiene at home by regular disinfecting the commonly touched surfaces like the doorknobs, the door handles, etc. And very important is that in the recent wave, the disease has shown a different characteristic. It is spreading much faster. More people are, you know, displaying symptoms like fever and cough and difficulty in breathing. As compared to last year, the number of symptomatic has doubled and even tripled in some of the areas. More people are requiring hospitalization and oxygen support. So it is very, very important that we have to prevent the disease. So how can we do that? Remember that when we have one infection, there are probably 25 other cases in the community who are infected, but they do not know. And we could be one of them. So remember that we are all together in this fight. So if I am safe, I can save others. And if others are safe, they can save me. So we have to take all the precaution. The 3 W's are very important. Wearing mask properly, covering the nose and mouth and chin at all times. Washing the hands frequently using sanitizers. So using sanitizers regularly, and watching your distance, keeping 6 feet away from others. And the 3 C's to be avoided: close and confined places, you know, cause problem with less ventilation. The second is close contact settings where people are sitting very close to each other. And the third is the crowded areas. So avoid these 3 C's: crowded areas, close confined spaces, and the close contact settings. So it is very important that we take all the precautions and we remain. Also, we stay at home because you know that when people move, the virus moves. When they stay at home, the virus stops moving. So we need to take all these precautions and stay safe till the pandemic is over, and that is not going to happen soon. So take all care, children. Stay safe. Get tested early if symptoms. Take all care. God bless.
We now present the small token of appreciation to Dr. Nilanjan Roy, and we thank him for all the important information he has given us today.